Now, I will show you how to externalize these things. Okay. So, with respect to Python, there is something called config parser package. And using config parser, you should be able to externalize the properties and run in local mode when you run in development environment and run in production mode. Run in yarn mode when you run in production environment. Okay. So, let me see if I have config parser. I think. So I will update this. I will update the code at a later point in time in the same topic. So you don't need to worry and search elsewhere. So to actually use the config parser, what you need to do is you have to have a properties file defined in a proper format. Okay. So one of the standard way of doing that is under source main, we create a directory just to make sure that it is organized properly. Again, you need to adhere to the project best practice. Okay, so here I am giving resources as the directory name, and then in this I will be creating a file called application.property. Okay, and as part of this application.properties, you can define properties in different ways. For example, if you want to define a property called execution mode, and if you want to run in local mode in development and yarn mode in production, you can create a category like this. So this is category, and all the properties under this dev in square brackets will be considered as dev properties. All the properties under prod with square brackets will be considered as prod properties. One thing you need to keep in mind is in each category the property names has to be same. Okay, they should not differ. So in this case, execution mode is local, and then input base directory equal to, so in dev I want to use this users itversity research data retail _db, and output base directory equal to users itversity research data bootcamp xpark. This is my output based directory. And it comes to production. In this case, the big data labs which we have, we are considering it as production. Okay. So in that, the input directory is /public retail db, and output based directory is user. I'll be connecting to training when I connect to the gateway node, training is the username, and for training there is the user space in HDFS, which is nothing but /user/training. In that, this is the location where I want to save my output. Okay. Now, once you have this, you can go to dailyrevenue.py, and here you can say import config parser. Okay. So config parser is the module which contains certain APIs to load the properties and read them with read them in a very straightforward way. We don't need to read the file and parse it and then define a dict and then access the properties with that. So there are there is a predefined functionality which is already provided to you as part of certain APIs under config parser. Okay. Once you import config parser, so let me import it as CP so that we can give we can use shortcut to access properties. And in the CP, we have something called raw config parser. Okay. So when you say props equal to CP dot raw config parser, it will create a object of the type. And this raw config parser have a have an API called read, and you can pass the path for your file. Okay. So in this case, the path for the file, path for the properties file should start from the base directory of the project. Okay. So it is nothing but source main resources and then application.properties. Okay. Once you have this, 1 minute. Okay. Once you have this, the properties will have a dict, and we can actually access the appropriate values for the keys using this dict. Okay. It is kind of a dictionary. So here, using this properties, once we use read, it will create a dict kind of object, and hence we can use APIs like get, okay, and we can actually get the section first, environment equal to props dot get. And when we actually invoke this application, when we are running in dev, we will be passing one argument to this program, and that argument will be dev. If we run it in production, we will be passing something like prod, because at runtime we need to tell which category of properties we should read, right? The only way to tell that is by using by using argument. So we have to pass the argument about the environment in which we are trying to run our code. Okay, so here to read the arguments, we need to import one more package called sys. I have already demonstrated when we covered Python in detail. And sys have APIs such as argv, which will facilitate you to read the arguments. So all the arguments will be available as a collection or list under sys with name argv. Okay, so in this case, the first argument will be, or probably the only argument for our program will be the environment in which we are trying to run. Using that, we will be reading the properties from application.properties. There is another way of dealing with this scenario. We can pass everything as everything as arguments. But if you pass everything as argument, and in a complex application, there can be 20, 30 or even 100 different arguments for your application. If you have to pass all those arguments at runtime, then the way you have to schedule the jobs will become overly complicated. To manage too many arguments, to manage too many properties or too many values, by avoid hard coding, externalizing properties the way I am demonstrating is much more better manageable compared to passing everything as argument. That's why externalizing properties is very, very important. Okay, so that being said, let me make sure that my YouTube session is going fine. Yeah, it is going fine. Okay, so that's why we are trying to understand how to read external properties at runtime. Only thing we need to keep in mind is we need to pass this argument to tell in which environment we are trying to run this job. Okay, so that is nothing but our first argument. So here, by saying sys.argv of 1, we are actually getting all the dev properties. So now let me create an env props. Now what env props will have is, it will have all the properties based on the argument which we pass. If it is dev, env props will have key value pairs of these three. Okay, if I pass the argument as plot, it will have key value pairs of these three. Okay, keys will be same, but the values will be different. They will be specific to the environment. That being said, there is one caveat which I need to take care. I need to copy this dailyrevenue.py to retail_daily. So I just moved into it. Earlier it was in the same level as retail_db, which is not correct. I want to create a different module for retail_db. Okay, that's why I just copied. Now you can see the hierarchy: source, main, Python, retail_db, and retail_db have dailyrevenue.py. Now let's go back here. From here, while setting, so I'll be removing this. Setting up the port, we'll be passing at runtime. I just want to show how we can actually pass additional properties than master and app name. That's why I have that. Now I removed it. Okay. Now this one, instead of hard coding with local, what I have to do? I have to use env props and then use get. Let me see. Okay. 1 minute. So it's a bit different. We should not do this way. Okay. So what we are supposed to do is, now I have to say, I will just give env. I will not be saying as env props. Okay. So when I say env equal to sys.argv of 1, so I'm telling what is the environment we are running in, and then using props.get. Okay. And if you look at here, if you look at .get, it takes two arguments. One is section and the second one is option. Okay. So section is dev or prod, and option is whatever is the value we want to retrieve by passing the name. So option is the name. So in this case, I have to say, sorry, I deleted the bracket accidentally. I have to say, oh my god. I have to say, get, first we have to give the section. The section is nothing but env here. And then we have to give the option. What is the option here? It is nothing but execution mode. Okay. So it will, if I pass dev, this will return local. If I pass prod, that will return yarn client. Okay. So now we have to even change the input path. Okay. So instead of hard coding the entire path, I am passing the base directory. Under the base directory, we have orders and order items, and that one have to be hard-coded in this case. In some times, we can also externalize even the directory names. It all depends upon design. But at least the base directory, you have to externalize and use that to read orders and order items dataset as per our design. So here, I have to say props. Dot get env, okay, and then concatenate. It takes one more argument, and this argument is nothing but input base directory. Okay? Same thing has to be done for this also, okay. And finally, we have to change this also. I'm just giving a unique name here, daily revenue app, and then here I have to say props dot get env output dot base dot dir, then concatenate with it. Okay, so this is how we can externalize the properties and take it from there. Now I can save it. Okay, once we save it, I can run it. So to run it, here now the program takes runtime argument. For that you have to go to wizard, which will facilitate us to update the runtime configurations for this application. Okay, if the application which you are trying to run is already available here, we just have to pass the script parameters like this. Okay, if it is not available, if it is, let's say it is deleted, and I'm saying okay, if you run this, it will complain that there is something missing because we are trying to access one argument here. As there is no argument passed to this program, it failed. Once it is failed, you can go to run and edit configurations, and you can see that in wizard. Okay, now you can just pass the script parameter and it will work. In some cases you might want to start from scratch. Okay, if you want to start from scratch, you can delete, choose Python here, and then choose the script here. So in our case, the script is nothing but ITversity PyCharm projects. Okay, and here we are talking about bootcamp PySpark source main Python retail DB daily revenue. You have to do it all manually. Once that is done, you can actually pass argument like this dev, and then as part of interpreter options, I don't think we need to take care of anything here. Let us try running it. If it fails, then we will see. Then you can say apply and then okay, and now you can actually say run daily revenue. It says no section dev. So working directory should be bootcamp spark, the actual project main directory. Okay, as it is actually gone to retail DB level, it is checking for retail DB and then source main resources application dot properties. That's the problem here. Now if I say run, now it is working. Okay, I will explain why it was failing and why it is working now. Let it run. Now it is successful. Okay, so what was happening is earlier, as part of the edit configuration, it was still this path, source main Python retail DB as part of working directory. So if you have already like this source main Python retail DB, okay, from here you have to specify the relative path as part of our program. This is one of the very common mistake people do. If they don't point working directory to the appropriate location, then it will be throwing as if there are no properties with that. Now as we have up to retail DB, if I right click and if I say run, it will say no section dev. To fix this, either you have to change the working directory, and from the working directory what we have, which is nothing but source main retail DB, we have to give the retail relative path. Okay, so let me explain here. Now our project directory is all the entire directory structure up to the bootcamp PySpark, and then it is source main retail DB. From here, where do we have resources? Resources is part of the parent directory of retail DB. That is what that is where we have resources. Okay, and then you have to give resources, and then you have to give application dot properties. So what does that mean? From this working directory, by saying dot dot, we are going to the parent directory of this, which is nothing but this, and then we are giving resources. So source main resources and application dot properties. So if you actually pass the path like this, and if you run it, it will work. It's not working. Okay, it is actually, I know what the problem. So it is source main Python retail DB. Okay, yeah, it is actually source main Python retail DB. Okay, so we have to give dot dot, means it will go to source main Python, but resources is under source main. So I have to say dot dot once again, so it will actually take us to source main, and then we are going to resources, and then we are going to application dot properties. You can see here, as we already saved the data to this location, it might be throwing exception. For now, I will give a different path here, then it should work. 01. Okay, and then you can right click and you can say run. Now from the working directory, it can figure out where the application properties is. So this is based upon our working directory. Okay, but when we actually take it to production and when we try to run it on a production cluster, we will be using the project's base directory as the working directory, and from there the application dot properties is readable using this location only, source main resources and application dot properties. And if you have to use this, then, and if you want to validate as part of PyCharm, you have to fix the working directory to point to the base directory of your project, which is nothing but bootcamp PySpark. Then say apply and then say okay.